Dame Emma Thompson, welcome to the project.
Thank you very much. I'm delighted to be here.
Just the pleasantries out of the way. Do I have to call you Dame? Is that...
Yeah, just Dame will do it.
No, just Dame.
Just
not
Dame.
Not even Dame.
Hey, Dame. No. Just call me Emma. But I could say anything, couldn't I? Because
yeah.
You don't know.
No.
I could have just said, you've just got to call me Dame E.T. or Dami. I could have said anything because this strange, abstruse thing has been attached to me. No, it's, you absolutely don't have to call me.
Is it fun being a Dame, though?
You mean not on a day-to-day basis? No, it doesn't change anything about your daily existence,
right.
But occasionally you might... It's occasionally... Is it useful? I don't know. Not really. It's just nice to have been acknowledged in that way.
Mm.
And because women aren't in that level of echelon of being recognised very often, and that's all beginning to change, but it's so slow. Having been offered it, it's probably unwise to say no.
Yeah, that's probably right. So you're very passionate about this film. Clearly, it means a lot to you.
It does.
You've been in such a huge variety of roles, and yet it seems to me you've somehow managed to find one that's different from all the others. Was it a unique challenge for you?
Yes, it was. I mean, you know, the wonderful thing about Nancy, the character I play, is she's the person who's normally standing next to or in the background or in the family of the person who's doing the interesting thing.
Yeah.
But suddenly, she's the one doing the interesting thing and she's the one who's central to the movie, to the story. And that was irresistible to me because she's done everything right. And then with this one act, she crosses every single boundary she's ever placed around herself or that has ever been placed around her. And there are many around women, and particularly of her age, of her generation and her upbringing. I've never done anything interesting in my life. You're the only adventure I've ever had. Now, let us not underestimate the power of being a good girl in all cultures, not a good boy. Good boys are encouraged to be, you know, out there and breaking the rules, and that's because he's a boy, because boys get to be adventurous and tough, and, you know, they can do wild things because they're boys.
Yeah.
But if women do that, then they're considered, well, if it's sex, then it's slutty, slut shame, all that nonsense. Or if they're angry, oh, God forbid they should be angry. So the good girl box is, you know, it's big and you tick it again and again and again. And the ways in which you tick it, you do a decent job. She's been a religious education teacher for 40 years. You know, she's done that. Then motherhood, big tick, boy, girl.
Yeah.
Do you know what? I'm not sure whether I would have had them had I known.
Yeah.
They're like a weight around my neck. How many women feel that and would never be able to say it? You know, we have to realise, zeitgeisty-wise, that for women, not much has changed. So it was fascinating to watch her say, I'm going to jump off this cliff now.
Yeah.
You know?
And what a cliff to jump off.
What a cliff. I simply don't understand why you're doing this.
This to save up for our college.
Oh, how wonderful. Are you really?
No.
One thing I found interesting in some of the press coverage of it, of the film so far, is a description of your role and you taking on the role as brave, which I thought was an interesting word to use. How do you see this role for you?
The reason people say it's brave is because female iconography is impossibly perfect and Nancy presents with a body that's just normal. So what they're saying is it's very brave of you to be old and fat and be on camera. That's what they're saying, though. You have to understand that's what they're saying. So, in fact, it's just a sort of synonym for not looking like, for instance, Charlize Theron.
Right.
And what I always think is if you want to see a change in the world, you absolutely have to try and be the change.
Yeah.
So the response is that people feel released from the agony and the restriction of our present iconography, which we have to change. We've just got to do something about that. There are 8-year-old girls out there complaining about their thighs.
Mm.
We have to understand that this is something that isn't acceptable. It's not acceptable that our young children are going, I don't look right. Mm.
In my job, I've had a lot of conversations about age with a lot of people of different ages. And I've noticed that the decade where people seem happiest and then think this is the decade seems to be their 60s. Uh-huh. And that's where you are now. So you're perfectly placed to confirm or deny. Is that true?
No.
Okay.
No, actually. Not that I don't get... Not that I'm not free. I am free of a lot of things. But I'm also suddenly very aware of dying.
Oh.
And that's very interesting.
Right.
But it's also... I'm not frightened of dying at all. I don't mind the idea of dying at all. But it's a very specific moment, that decade, this decade, because people do start to die, and you suddenly go, oh, better start thinking about that. Better start really getting to grips with that idea.
Yeah. Right.
And that's another theme in the film, you know, because Nancy doesn't want to die without having, well, contained herself, known herself. Mm. You know, that would be sad, perhaps.
Right.
So I suppose it's all connected, isn't it?
Yeah. It's funny, yeah. I wasn't expecting to end up in this deeper place, but it makes perfect sense.
It does, doesn't it, really?
When you think about death then, how do you respond to that thought?
Oh, I mean, I think it'll be a huge relief, don't you? Just finally you don't have to do anything anymore.
Well, we've been very lucky to have a slice of your time. Today.
Well, it's not very long. Sure, there's nothing else you want to ask.
Oh, there's
me.
Lots, but I'm being told that I have to
wrap. Well, you can ask me some more.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Because I know there are people here who are going to get very angry with
Let's
me.
Let's do... So. He's come, this is a very important thing, and I'm here. I've travelled a long way. Thank you.
With the extra time from Emma, I couldn't help but ask about that scene from Love Actually.
Friends, oh, my God!
I don't know if you're sick of talking about this or not, but there's something...
Yes, I am. But do ask.
Okay,
I mean, I'm going to be honest with you because this is the project, you know. You need people to be honest and authentic.
Oh, I'm more than happy.
It's not that I'm sick of talking about it. It's just I'm completely fascinated that it's still there. So what is it that so kind of engages people with it? It's because everybody knows what it's like to have to hide pain.
Yes.
Everyone knows that... Something can happen inside your body, your heart can shatter into a million pieces and tinkle down like teeth in Tom and Jerry cartoons into the bottom of your soul and sit shards of your heart in your stomach, and you still got to smile
carry on.
And that's just such a human... I think that's what it is. I mean, people used to stop me on the tube and go, it's very... touching, really.
Yeah. I'm surprised you gave me 10 minutes I wasn't entitled to.
No, you were so entitled.
I'm very grateful to
Not
you.
Not at all.
Thank
it was
you so
a
much
lovely
for
interview. To Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, my goodness. I'm just sitting here like this the whole time. I'm
great.
Surprised you weren't doing that there.
I mean, well, if I did that, I think she would have found that quite odd. To be fair.
I can't confirm or deny whether or not I was the person on the tube being
like everyone else in the world, really. Good luck to you. Leo Grand premieres in cinemas on Thursday, the 18th of August.